after the Solheim was probably the last good thing from 17 on, and then it wasn't until this year, or maybe at the end of last year, I started to find a little bit of golf again. So it's been a long run with bad golf, but it's super nice to be playing well again and being in contention and kind of feel like my work's going somewhere.
Did you ever feel that you weren't going to get back to how you were playing?
Well, at some point, no, I didn't. I thought about, well, maybe I should apply to go do some studying or whatever. But then we sat down and I kind of finally accepted that it's not good. It's not where it was. But then we set a goal that I didn't just want to get back to where I was. I wanted to come out of it even better. And I feel like I've accomplished that, because obviously the playoff in Scotland was the best on the LPGA I've ever done. And it was my best major finish and then a win. So it was kind of very nice for me to get out of it and feel like, okay, this is better than when I came into the bad stretch.
Coming into the Scottish tournament, did you feel that week was coming then? You already felt that the work was working.
I felt that I was playing better. I felt that my work had been kind of in the right direction, because I played an amateur event and I played on the Echo Tour and I did really well, but I didn't think I was going to get in the playoff, because it was always like, okay, this is, now it really counts kind of, and I was thinking, still need to figure out where am I at when the real pressure's on. So it felt really good to kind of prove that I wasn't just good at an amateur event or at a third level men's, but also where I want to be good at.
Yeah, I mean, because that was a truly world-class field in Scotland, and then of course over to the major, and once again it was a great week there, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was. It was really cool to kind of show as well that it wasn't just a one-time pop-up thing, but it was kind of building in, and I played really good all of August really, and then hopefully I can bring it on to the rest of the season.
And now I guess it's a different kind of pressure when you're playing so well that you turn up to an event like this and suddenly you are the favourite. How are you handling that side of it now?
Well, I'm trying to handle it, but it's, I said that when I was home, I was like, I came to Scottish, no one expected absolutely anything of me, and now I'm flying to Switzerland and I'm the highest ranked on the world ranking and the favourite, and I'm like, how do I deal with that? And then we were like, well, just try and do the same thing.
Suddenly the spotlight's on you.
Yeah, but it feels so much better than not being in any kind of spotlight, I can tell you that, because I've been that the last 2 years, so I'll take this. I mean, it's obviously different, and you know, your heart's pumping in another way, like it's pumping when you're about to miss the cut or when you have another terrible week, but it's fun. I mean, this is at the end of the day what we play for, and the goal is to be in the spotlight, because if you're in the spotlight, you're playing good golf. So I want to win the race to Costa del Sol, and obviously if I could have another win, that would be great. We said before coming into this season, before all the lockdowns and everything, we said the goal was to be in contention twice this year. I already have been, so now the goal is to win the race to Costa del Sol. I want to get back into the Solheim, but it's not just about getting into the Solheim Cup, it's about winning points for Europe, and I think that's a lot better mentality for me this year. It's like, I think I got there and I was kind of satisfied with just getting there, and I want to win points now. I want to lift the trophy. It's about a lot more than that. I want to beat the Americans so bad. So I want to be in the team, but I want to be in the team not just to be in the team, but to win, if that makes sense.
Yeah, you want to be a key part of the team.
Yeah, I do.